My guess is you're chomping at the bit to start editing with Premiere Pro, so we're going to get that process underway in this lesson. I'm going to show you a couple of ways to start up a new project, a couple other ways to open an existing project, and walk you through the process to sync your settings with the Adobe Creative Cloud. So first of all, we're going to start up Premiere Pro, and I'm going to do that by double-clicking my icon here in the desktop. If you don't have an icon on your desktop, you can always go to the Start menu, or go to the Dock on a Mac, or find the file itself inside a file folder. But I'm going to double-click on this now. Get the splash screen, and then I get this Welcome to Adobe Premiere Pro dialog box. There are a few things of note here. Recent items. Now, if you've been noodling around inside Premiere Pro, you're going to see a few things here. Otherwise, that'll be empty. There's an Open Project button and a Create New Project button there, and a few learning items over here. And finally, the Sync Settings Now for Adobe Creative Cloud. I'm just going to click on this to get started. This is a fairly straightforward process. The purpose is simply to authenticate your product and also to link to any preferences that you have online that are cross-product preferences. I'm not going to go through the process here, but basically just put in your email address and then your Adobe ID password and go from there. And once you do that, you'll see your email address showing up right there. But now I want to talk about opening up a new project, and we'll do that from this dialog box and do it from within Premiere Pro later. I'm going to click on this little button here. That opens up this new project dialog box. Just consider a project to be kind of a container. It's where you store all the links to your assets and also store your sequences. Sequences are the timelines, the thing that you create when you're putting together a project. And you can have multiple sequences inside a project and as many assets as you want. Assets include things like video files, audio files, graphics, and still images, as much as you want. So let's just give the project a name. I'm going to call it Test Project. And now you need to give it a file folder location, so I click on Browse. I go to my desktop. I've got this file folder that I set up just for this purpose for temporary storage of things called my Premiere Pro Exercise file. So I just double click on that and say that is my folder. And then I need to do a couple things here. Under this general tab, I've got video rendering and playback. If you have an Adobe approved GPU accelerator, it'll show up here. And you really should select that if you've got it. There's no reason not to. So I've got that selected there in my case. And the default display format is timecode, but you might want to use feet and frames if you're working with film that's been transferred to video. The display format for audio is samples, which is better than milliseconds because you can actually do per sample editing. And you typically work with audio from video. It's about 48,000 samples a second, so that can be very precise. Then the capture format, if you're going to capture from tape, are you going to capture from DV or HDV? And the thing is, you can change this later. The whole scratch disk concept can be a little confusing. This is where you store things that you acquire or create as you are working inside a project. So if you capture video, for example, from tape, do you want to store it on some separate drive than your regular hard drive? If you want to capture audio, same kind of a thing. You may create video previews when you're working on a project, and you typically do that when you apply a lot of effects to a video clip, and it slows things down because the effects cause the CPU to work extra hard. And so you can have Premiere Pro make a preview, a compressed file that will then display whenever you want to see that part of your project. And so where do you store all these things? Well, the old thinking was you stored them on a separate hard drive because you didn't want to slow down the hard drive that has your assets on it in general. But the thing is, these days, hard drives are pretty fast anyways. And when you play these things, you're not playing them with other files at the same time. So I just accept the defaults here. I have them stored at the same place as my project. I don't think it's really necessary to put them on a separate location, so I accept the defaults here, which is the same as my project location. Very simple. Once I've done that, I click OK, and that creates a project file. Now, in the previous version of Premiere, you had an intermediary step there where you had to create a sequence before you could actually see this interface in front of you. And I always told people to skip that because it was unnecessary. Well, now, maybe Adobe was listening because they got rid of that intermediary step. There is no need to create a sequence. But let me show you what happened when you created the project file. I'm going to minimize this for a second here and go get my exercise files folder here and show you that there is that file, the project file, and then there's automatically an Adobe Premiere Pro preview folder. This is where you store those preview files if you make them. It has this test project PRV folder, and you go inside there, but there's nothing in there. Things go in there only if you purposely make them, and most times you won't. So there sits this empty folder, but that's the process when you create a new project file. In addition, as you work inside this project, you'll start getting auto-saves. Premiere Pro automatically saves your project every few minutes. You set the time limit inside your preferences. So you're going to get an auto-save folder here, just in case things go south on you and your computer shuts down or the thing freezes up or whatever, you've got this auto-save that you can use to resurrect your project. So that'll show up a little bit later as you work inside Premiere Pro. All right, now we're back in Premiere Pro with this new project loaded up, and it's empty. Nothing's been loaded up here. But where you load things up is here inside the project panel. And I want to remind you that when you work with projects here in Premiere Pro, you're not moving your assets around. You're not copying and pasting video files and putting them someplace on your hard drive. You're just creating links to them here inside the project panel. And when you add your assets to the timeline, again, you're not copying and pasting them or moving them. The timeline simply plays them directly off the hard drive from wherever they're located on the hard drive. Also, as a reminder, you can have as many assets here as you want and as many sequences as you want that run inside the timeline in any given project. And usually, you organize your projects by a topic. You might have an overarching corporate project, for example, with a number of different stories inside there, different sequences about different products that you sell, something like that. What that means, though, is that you don't have to have a separate project for each topic that you're working on, but you will probably want to have multiple projects at some point. So when you're working inside a project, you can also start a new project from within Premiere Pro. To do that, you go to File, New, Project, and it'll ask you to save the previous project you're working on if there's anything inside there. In our case, there's nothing there, so it didn't ask us to save. And we get this new project dialog box again, the same thing we did before. I'm going to cancel out of that. That'll take us back to the splash screen here, where we can open an existing project. Now, if you've got the recent items here and the thing you're looking for is there, it's fine. You just click on it. But if it's not there, you click on Open Project. In our case, we're going to go to the Working Files folder on the desktop here. Working Files. Go to Projects. And the projects are listed here. I'll pick a later one here just to show you how to do that. I'm going to double-click on 2103 Export Sequences, but you can open any one you want. Choosing this one because it has a number of different files on it and a timeline here, a sequence inside the timeline. So that's how you open a project via that splash screen. Or you can open a project from within Premiere Pro, again, by going File, Open Project. And if I did any changes to that previous one, it asked me to save it, but I'll open up this one here, for example, double-clicking on it. Same kind of process as before. Now I'm going to close this down. And if you want to open a project directly, you go right to the Working Files, for example, go to Projects, select one of these guys. I'll just double-click on this one here. And that's how you open a project, just by double-clicking on the project itself, and that'll open up Premiere Pro with that project loaded up. So that's how you start a new project, open an existing project, and sync your settings to the Adobe Creative Cloud.